I'm really frustrated because I want to wear these glasses, but you keep seeing the glare of my ring light. Also, like, can we not with the fire trucks right now? Okay, so I remember when I first moved into my first studio and I was looking at videos on YouTube on how to live in a studio and what to do and what's the best way to prepare. And I could not for the life of me find any videos on where people actually put their stuff. There's so many videos of studio apartment tours and they're beautiful, but no one explains where the heck they put their stuff. They just put it all away for the video and then show you their beautifully, aesthetically pleasing, minimalistic studio, which trust me, I'm all about. And I consider myself like a decent amount of a minimalist. I still have things and they need to go places. This is a video on studio apartment secrets. Where the heck do you put all your stuff? Now, I bet you couldn't tell. Even just in this shot, I have like two different hiding places for stuff. This couch is one of my favorite things because not only does it pull out into a double bed, but it also has storage under here. This opens, and then down in here we keep all of our guest bedding, a tray, and I could fit a lot more. But having this space is crucial because if we didn't have this, like, I don't know where a lot of this stuff would go. We don't own a broom, but if we did, that broom would probably go in here. Honestly, I have a mop and my mop should go in here. I might move it in here tonight. It's long and it's deep, so this is a really great place to hide stuff. If you can find a couch with storage, or maybe instead of doing a coffee table, getting an ottoman that has storage in it, those are simple ways that you can hide stuff away really easily. Also, there's this crack right here that no one can ever see because the arm of the couch comes to here, but then the couch isn't as wide as the arm, so there's like a 6-inch crack and it's probably about 2.5 feet long. I keep my throw blanket down there. My throw blanket's not, sir. You're very up in my business. My throw blanket isn't super aesthetically pleasing. It's like my t-shirt quilt from college, but it's comfortable and I love it and I'm not getting rid of it. So I just hide it down in this little area all the time whenever I am not using it. And that way you don't see it and my couch looks beautiful and clean. Another example of where to put things that you don't know where else it should go is if you're gonna do like a side table, make sure you get a side table that can hide things. For example, everyone, this is Louie and that is Louie's dog bed. And Louie's dog bed goes inside of this table, which is underneath this plant. So it's perfect because he has his own little space that he loves and can go in there, but I don't have to have the floor space taken up from a dog bed because it's incorporated into this table. Another easy hack is my mirror right here. So my mirror is actually blocking off like a corner. It's not flush against the wall. So I have all of this corner space. This is hard to show. Behind this corner, there is just, oh, I almost dropped my mirror. Oh my gosh, okay. So back here is just all of the stuff that I don't want seen. So it's extra pot plants, some dirt, some clothes we're getting rid of, a bunch of stuff like that just lives behind this mirror. And then when we're not using it, the mirror just goes back up and you can't even tell we're hiding a bunch of stuff back there. That one is super handy. If you have a ridiculously tiny kitchen like I do and you need to get a rolling island, make sure you get one with cabinets. There's so many islands and countertops that are just metal bars. There's some shelves that you can put stuff in, but mine has full cabinet doors and it has drawers. So this thing holds a lot and it doesn't take up that much space. And especially if you need some sort of table, this is a great option because you can put a lot of stuff in it. I'm abandoning the ring light because it's just killing me softly. Next, if you have any vertical space at all in your entire apartment, make sure to use it. Whether you are using it with storage boxes like I have up here, or if you can only do like those IKEA cubes, whatever you can do, utilize your vertical space. That will save you so much room. You can tuck all sorts of stuff up there. Oh, and I forgot to mention, if you don't have a couch like this and you already have a couch and you're just keeping it, you can still store a bunch of stuff under it. You can either get those under the bed storage boxes from IKEA or just put like your broom and vacuum and stuff underneath them. I used to do that in my old studio, and if you haven't seen my old studio apartment tour, definitely check that one out. That video is super old, but it still has a lot of really good tips in there. And the last place that everyone should be using for their storage is under the bed. I have so much stuff underneath my bed. I don't know if you can see, there's a backpacking backpack, a golf bag. There's usually a full set of golf clubs. There's two guitars under there. It's ridiculous how much we've squeezed under there. Under the bed is the best place for storage because it's totally out of sight, out of mind. We got a bed frame that is, I think it's 18 inches tall, which is pretty tall for just a bed frame. We don't have a box spring or anything on it. It holds so much stuff. We have two suitcases under there. It's crazy. And then all you have to do is get a bed skirt. And so then you never have to look at any of it because it's just tucked away, but it's all there perfectly accessible. possible for you. So those are just some of my go-to, like, quickest and easiest tips on where you can store stuff away. I have been living in a studio now for 1.5 years and I love it, but you need to figure out where you're gonna put all of your stuff. If you liked this video and found it the least bit helpful, please give it a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button. I post videos for tips, tricks, and organization for small space living. And if you have any questions for me, definitely comment down below. If you haven't already, definitely follow me on Instagram. My Instagram is @CairaButton. I post all sorts of content, a lot of my studio and just my general life, and I would love to be able to connect with more of you. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.